My last presentation is not related to the other ones. It's related to the publishing features that were added to Oxygen, and mainly about Oxygen PDF chemistry. So, being a newer member of our product suite, maybe I should mention what chemistry is. So it's basically a converter from XML and CSS to PDF. So some reasons for using CSS for print. If you are not already convinced, so the alternative to using CSS is using XML-FO. And if someone needs to hire people to write XML-FO, there is a smaller talent base than finding people to write CSS. Another advantage of using CSS for people that use Oxygen is that they already have a CSS file for the XML content in the author page. So if they have a custom XML vocabulary and they are authoring it in Oxygen XML author, they already have a CSS to render it. So that it's a very good starting point for creating a CSS for print. It still needs to be adjusted, but it's a very good starting point. Another advantage is that if you publish documentation on multiple channels, the web version and the PDF version can use the same styling, and so the users will, the readers of the documentation will feel at home when reading something which is published using web help or PDF or EPUB, which also uses CSS and so on. So you offer them a more consistent user experience. Also, CSS it's easier to customize. You just write another CSS selector, write exclamation mark important, and you can change everything. I was joking. There are better tools to develop CSS for an XML. We have this CSS inspector tool in Oxygen, and we also have, and in the browsers there are also dev tools. So in Oxygen you can right click on an element and say inspect styles. And then, so here is an element which is called code, and the only style associated is that it has a monospace font. Here is a paragraph that has a margin top, a margin bottom, and display block, and so on. And also in the browser, there is this developer tools that you can open pressing F12, for example, and they even have a checkbox for choosing whether to emulate print media, and they start to look at some CSS constructs that are normally ignored for web pages. I'm not sure where that is. I mean, it has to be somewhere here. Here is emulate CSS media type print. Yeah, so here, this is web author if it was printed on paper, maybe. Okay. And also, as you've seen also here, that there are a lot of companies investing in providing tools for CSS for print. There was the other session in the other room. Some companies are Antenna House, Prince XML, Doc Raptor, and I'm sure I'm missing some of them. Having so many tools that are basically CSS for print processors, why would one choose our chemistry engine? First of all, it is free to use if you have Oxygen XML editor, so it's a good option. And at some point, if your publishing needs scale up, you can buy a commercial license and you can run it on a build server. It works on any operating system, so if someone has a Mac OS, can still try to run locally some transformation scenarios. You already know that we have a responsive support team and extensive documentation. As I told you, we basically, most of the support incidents are either answered by an existing tutorial in our user manual, or we add another one. So we have this this big chapter in our user manual, and each topic has some sections about, for example, accessibility, about the cover title page. So here are a lot of, so these are the built-in rules, how to add the background image, how to change the styling, how to add text to the cover page, how to place the cover page on the right or left side, how to add specific number of empty pages after the cover page, and so on. So there are a lot of specific use cases. So I'm not going to do another tutorial on CSS for print, because there were already two in the other room. So I will try to highlight what what CSS constructs are supported in chemistry. So we support the basic CSS that is used also also in web browser, like color, border, display, font, size, and so on. We also implement the CSS page media module specification, which includes things like multiple columns. I created a small application that can be used to see how chemistry generates PDF, providing the XML and the CSS. This is hosted on Heroku, so it slips if it's not in use. So here we have a page with two columns, and the H1, the main title, spans all the columns, and also I added a rule saying that a paragraph should avoid breaking to another column. So this is a long paragraph, so the chemistry processor prefers to end the column earlier rather than splitting this paragraph on two columns, because that's how I configured it to do. Okay. There are also other configurations. For example, here I have a book with multiple chapters, and here this chapter has a black square on the right. This is the first chapter. The second chapter has another black square on the right, but is a bit lower than the previous one. So it basically implements this phone book feature. So when you look at the book from the side, you can see black squares where each section starts. So if you want to go to the third section, you open it directly. And yeah. So and for this feature, we use some Oxygen specific extensions like Oxy XPath. And I have a couple of more examples, but I'm not going to click through all of them. So besides the basic CSS and the CSS page media module, we support some Oxygen-specific extensions. So Oxy XPath is like the calc function in CSS, but is much better. So basically, you can compute the value of a CSS property based on the XML structure. You can so in this example, the chapter title was had the number of columns equal to the number of preceding chapters, something like this. So basically on the right part of the page, we add a black square, but before it we enter new line characters for a couple of times, and that number of times is equal to the number of preceding siblings. And that's something that you can easily implement using Oxy XPath. We also support pseudo elements like before and after. It is a hard problem in XML when you try to achieve a layout, because you cannot create new elements as you can in HTML. In HTML, you write some JavaScript, add new elements and style them. In XML, you have to style those existing elements. So we implement before and after pseudo elements. But we also implement an unlimited number of before and after elements. So you can before an element, you can write, you can add let's say an icon, then some text, and then another icon, and you can put all of them in one pseudo element. But if you put them in different pseudo elements, you can change the font size, the whether it's block or inline, and so on. So it's, for some cases, this is useful. We also support rendering change tracking and change bars in PDF. There are also some custom CSS properties to specify the accessibility tag of an element. So you can say that an element is a table, even if it doesn't have the table style, and so on. And also, it has a way to configure how hyphenation works, to configure how many letters should be before breaking the word on two lines. I wanted to focus on a CSS for print challenge, which I also mentioned earlier, that you cannot create new elements. So let's say I have a docbook document and I want to publish it, but it also include a table of contents at the beginning. If you wrote an HTML page, you would use JavaScript to create that table of contents. And also some PDF for print tools are allow running JavaScript before in one of their stages before converting to PDF. In Oxygen PDF chemistry, we thought that XSRT does a very good job for creating additional elements, and you can implement a multi-stage pipeline. For example, in the first part, you generate a table of contents using XSRT, and then you create the PDF using chemistry. So, for example, for DocBook, I try to implement a style sheet that generates a table of contents. So, it basically, first of all, it generates IDs for any section or article, and then it creates an element called PDF, which is the root of the new XML that is going to be published. And first of all, it generates a table of contents, and then it copies the content that has IDs associated with in every section. And that document is not DocBook anymore, but it's just an intermediary step in our publishing pipeline, so it doesn't have to be valid DocBook, because the CSS rules will apply anyway. And the resulting structure should be like this. Configure, so DocBook TOC, apply. So so here is the PDF synthetic root element. Then I have talk entry elements that have the title taken from the content, and internal links to the IDs here. And then it's just a matter of CSS to render the table of contents with small dots and so on. Okay, so publishing from Oxygen XML editor is very easy and is free, but sometimes when you want to scale up publishing, you need to automate things. Automating the publishing can help in several ways. For example, when you publish from your laptop, you run, if you want to create like 10 deliverables, you have to create them one at a time. While on a server, you can run them in parallel on multiple machines. Also, you can do this more often. Like you can run a job that several times a day will generate the all the deliverables. So your work will be more visible inside the company, because they will see how the documentation evolves. Also, since you publish faster, you will see publishing related errors faster. Maybe you started to use some DocBook element that was not used before, and the publishing scripts are not configured properly to handle that element. And you also save work hours, because while you are publishing, you cannot do some jobs that you would normally do. So for this reason, we created a new product, which is called Oxygen Publishing Engine. So the goal of this product is that if I manage to publish from Oxygen, then it should be very simple to do that on a build server. Currently, the Oxygen Publishing Engine works with DITA content. It includes a DITA open toolkit, and our plugins for web help and chemistry. To start it, so publishing engine is just a zip archive with all the required tools, and it has the entry point is the dita.bat script, and you just say --- input and the dita map. The publishing template, which is the configuration file for publishing, and the format, which is PDF, CSS, HTML5. The Oxygen Publishing Engine also contains some additional plugins, like the one to generate a DITA metrics report, the one that generates edit links that open web author, plugins to embed video, audio, and general iframes in the content, to run syntax highlights on code blocks and to float images and so on. So with this tool, you have the Oxygen publishing template, which is a tool provided by Oxygen, and then all the configuration that you want for a deliverable is saved in one file, which is called Oxygen publishing template. For a PDF, it has several sections, like a CSS section that you give the CSS to be used. It has a parameters section. You can say whether figure titles in Dita should be generated on top of the image or at the bottom of the image. And you can also provide XSLT scripts that perform some tweaks on the intermediary format that is used to publish Dita content. These CSS files here, there can be many of them, and one nice thing is that the same publishing template can be used for both PDF and web help. And you can isolate a file that contains the content, the common rules, and then have a separate one for web help and for PDF. I also wanted to show you another tool that we have for generating these CSS files, which is basically a visual designer. So it's called Oxygen Styles Basket, available at styles.oxygenxml.com. So basically here you can, without even thinking about CSS, you can use the font size, like this, 14, 12. You can choose the table of contents, numbering, the page size. You can choose this if it's an A3, A4, and so on. Our plans for Oxygen Publishing Engine are to extend it beyond Dita and basically to run any transformation scenario that you can run in Oxygen from the command line on the build server. And you still benefit from the intuitive configuration UI that you have in Oxygen to define the configuration scenario, and the execution core will be the same as in Oxygen. So you don't have to configure things once for Oxygen and another time for the build server. Okay, so this is
support for to export transformation scenarios. So once you have that file, you can just point to the name of the scenario.
Yeah. So this concludes my last presentation. If you have questions,
yes.
Okay. I have a question. I'm always interested in doing things like this. But he will ask me if this prepress ready. So does it support other color models than RGB? Does it support manipulating boxes in the PDF, like trim boxes and things like that? So does it have that kind of extensions?
For other color spaces, like HSC,
for instance, or process colors?
To functions like lighter?
No, you want to say, I want a percentage of yellow and a percentage of black and things like that, or I want just this Pantone color with that name.
I see. I'm not sure if you... So chemistry supports less, which compiles to CSS, and I think less has some support for converting between color spaces.
Okay. Well, I have a look.
Yeah.